It's the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. First of all, a thank you to each one of you for all the many ways in which you participate in the life of this congregation. Even if you are a guest or visitor today as a first-timer, welcome, and we're glad that you are here and blessed by your presence as we praise God together. Last Sunday, we had Pastor Appreciation Sunday, so Pastor Vern and I both got these big cards, as well as Priscilla, our organist and accompanist, who's been with us for 30 years at St. Mark's. And I'm back today. Pastor Vern is not, and neither is Priscilla. I don't know what that says, but no, thank you very much, and we appreciate Caroline today for filling in for Priscilla as well. In addition to that, take a look at your announcement page. It's that single piece of paper with all sorts of different announcements on it, including a blessing of pets or blessing of the animals later this afternoon out front of St. Mark's Sanctuary. We indeed will probably be trying to bless things like panthers and dolphins and eagles and cardinals and, the teams that can't win, even the Bears. Not the Lenore Iron Bears. They continue to be undefeated, along with Mooresville High School and Lake Norman High School, right? Those area teams. Anyway, a couple of other announcements are going to be made by Jane. So, Jane, come on up, if you will.
So, obviously, if I'm up here, you probably all know this is for the youth. Just some really quick announcements. One, October 28th, this is on the front side of your announcement page, is our trunk or treat. We still need help. I've had a lot of questions about candy donations. We do not need candy. We have two huge totes full of candy, as well as the welcome bags pretty much already packed. But we do still need volunteers to help with like cleanup, setup, and some of the other things that happen throughout the event. November 11th, we're hosting a fall craft market. That's on the back side of your announcement page. That is open to crafters, vendors, and local small businesses. We have currently 50 booths we will be setting up in the field out front. We still can take on some more vendors, so if you know somebody or you yourself has a business that you want to set up, just let me know and we'll get that set up for you. November 19th, we will be having our annual Thanksgiving feast for those in our congregation 55 and older. We will have our youth serving you another Thanksgiving feast. This year, we do need some extra donations as we've had a change of hands with the turkey donations. So we will have a sign up coming out for that, but we do need some additional donations this year. And then on December 10th, Santa is coming to visit our youth. This will be a ticketed breakfast event as a fundraiser for our youth headed to the gathering next summer. We will be doing a Pancakes with Santa breakfast event, and we'll have more information on that, but also we'll be taking some donations as well for that event. So those are all our upcoming youth events. And then one other non-youth piece of information, we have two of the three rental houses currently empty. So if anybody is one of those people that enjoys cleaning, we could use some help cleaning. And we're not talking light cleaning. We're talking deep, hard cleaning of our two rental homes that are empty so that we can get them on the market for sale. So if you are interested in helping out with that, please see me as well. Thank you.
Thank you.
Please stand as you're able. And please join me. Blessed be God, the one who forms us, Jesus who bears the cross, the Holy Spirit who makes our joy complete. Amen. Let us bow before God in humility, confessing and repenting of all our sin. Steadfast and faithful God, you have revealed the ways of justice and mercy, yet we fail to follow you. We are overwhelmed by the world's violence and suffering. We are afraid to risk what we have for the sake of others, for the harm we have caused, known and unknown. Forgive us for the unjust demands we place on others and your creation. Forgive us for the ways we turn away from you and our neighbor. Forgive us. For your name's sake, lead us back on the paths of righteousness. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. God does renew and uphold us with his free spirit given to us, the free gift of Christ and by God's grace, so that therefore, even when we are dead in sin, we are made alive together with Christ. By grace you have been saved, and in the name of Jesus Christ, your sins are forgiven. Almighty God, strengthen you with power through the Holy Spirit, that Christ may live in your hearts through faith. Amen. Savior. Lord God, our shepherd, you have prepared a table before all peoples and poured out your life with abundance. Call us again to your banquet. Strengthen us by what is honorable, just, and pure, and transform us into a people of righteousness and peace. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Sharon's name is on the back of the bulletin as our lector today. I believe she is in Pennsylvania. Her husband, Dave, died a couple of months ago, and today they're having, or this weekend and the next couple of days, having memorial service for Dave Gomboots there in Allentown, Bethlehem area, Pennsylvania. So I'll go ahead and share Isaiah 25 with us, and then we'll all pray together Psalm 23. I will say that this is the appointed first reading today, along with Psalm 23. Isaiah 25, especially the first several verses, can be maybe traumatizing, especially if you've paid attention to the week's news, especially from Israel and Hamas and Palestinians and all that over there, because Isaiah 25 speaks in the midst of that type of a situation. But then it goes on at verse 6, where I proclaim on this mountain, where Isaiah proclaims on this mountain. It is often read at funerals, that portion, because it talks about all peoples and how God will take care of us and wipe away the tears from our eyes. And then it's joined oftentimes in funerals with Psalm 23. I think that's an interesting connection today. Anyway, the first reading according to Isaiah chapter 25. O Lord, you are my God. I will exalt you. I will praise your name. For you have done wonderful things, plans from of old, faithful and sure. And that's why we gather here today, to praise God. But you, O God, have made the city a heap, the fortified city a ruin. The palace of aliens is a city no more. It will never be rebuilt, kind of like in the place of Hamas. Therefore, strong peoples will glorify you. Cities of ruthless nations will fear you. For you have made a refuge to the poor, a refuge to the needy in their distress, a shelter from the rainstorm and a shade from the heat. With a blast of the ruthless, it was like a winter rainstorm. The noise of the aliens was like heat in a dry place. Yet you, O God, subdued the heat with the shade of clouds, and you subdued the song of the ruthless. It was stilled. And on this mountain, O Lord of hosts, you will make for all peoples a feast of rich food, a feast of well-aged wines, of rich food filled with marrow, of well-aged wines strained clear. And you will destroy on this mountain, O God, the shroud that is cast over all peoples, the sheet that is spread over all nations. You will swallow up death forever. Then you, O Lord our God, will wipe away the tears from all faces, and the disgrace of your people you will take away from all the earth. For the Lord has spoken. It will be said on that day, Lo, this is our God. We have waited for him so that he might save us. This is the Lord for whom we have waited. Let us be glad and rejoice in his salvation. For the hand of the Lord will rest on this mountain. Here ends the reading. And then sometimes in funerals, Vince Gill starts singing, Rest High on That Mountain, or Go Rest High on That Mountain. Psalm 23, will you please join with me in praying that the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. I invite our children to come forward for our children's message. Good morning. Good morning. All right, can you repeat after me? The Lord is my shepherd.
The Lord is my
What does that mean? The Lord is my shepherd.
That he takes care of us.
That he takes care of us. Thank you very much. That's a perfect and a wonderful way of looking at that. The Lord is my shepherd. So I found a couple of lambs or sheep here. Maybe this is a mama or a daddy and a baby. Maybe this is an uncle or an aunt or a grandparent and a baby. Anyway, this one's smaller and this one's bigger. The Lord takes care of us. God takes care of us. How, if these were your sheep in real life, not just a stuffed animal, but if these were your sheep, how would you take care of them?
I would feed them food and make sure they don't.
All right. So Sullivan says feed them food and make sure they are not harmed. I think you said
it. Don't be the boy that cried wolf.
Don't be the boy that cried wolf either. Yeah, right? Wolf, wolf, wolf. And all of a sudden there's no wolf, right? And then there is a wolf.
Yeah.
So you tell the truth, you take care of, you feed. How else? Pass that cuddly sheep on down. Everybody gets a chance to hold it, hug a sheep. How else are you going to help take care of these sheep or lambs? Anyway, Cooper, how are you about you? You know something about taking care of animals.
Food, water, shelter.
All right. Yeah, do you get to scoop poop too? Yeah, sometimes that happens as well. Food, water, and shelter, taking care of. What else? Making sure that they are loved. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. Anybody else? Anybody else want to help? Yeah. How would you take care of a sheep, a lamb? How about at home? Do you guys help take care of pets? Yeah, we do have a pet blessing this afternoon. You have a dog? Do you help take care of the dog? Yeah? What does that mean?
Well, I don't actually.
You tuck your dog in at night underneath your blankets in the bed? No?
But I don't actually take care of him. My parents do, but he's my dog.
Okay, your parents actually do. Do you ever go walking with your dog? Walking with your cats?
At the bus stop.
At the bus stop, yeah. And you have two dogs and a cat? Okay, that's a lot to take care of. And where does the food come from?
The store.
The store, okay. And the water?
The ocean.
The ocean, the earth, the water, yeah. And does it just magically appear in the dog bowls or the cat bowls or the, no? How does it get in there? You have to help. You have to pour the food in there, okay? Yeah, very good. Very good. So we take care of things. That's another way. The Lord is my shepherd. Say that again with me. The Lord is my shepherd. The Lord is my shepherd. And after that, it says, I shall not be in want, because God provides us with everything. It goes on in that beautiful psalm to talk about how the many different ways God takes care of us, by feeding us and giving us shelter and water and clothing and protection, by keeping us from harm, by leading us in wonderful and beautiful places, and sometimes in scary places too. And even there, God is with us. So the Lord is my shepherd. You turn, say that. The Lord is my shepherd. It's a beautiful psalm and a beautiful prayer to remind us how God takes care of us and how we might take care of others and the world that God made, including our pets. Now, taking care of others, taking care of one another, taking care of things, the fancy word is called stewardship. Stewardship. Can you say stewardship? Mm-hmm. Stewardship, and that means taking care of. Taking care of everything that God has given us, including our own lives, including the talents that we have, including our church, including outside, including our pets. Right? We can all be shepherds. We can all be stewards. Right? All right. Let us pray. Dear God, thank you for being our shepherd. Thank you for providing all that we need and want. Thank you for people who help us to protect us and to watch over us, to feed and clothe us and provide us shelter. Thank you for people who help protect us. Thank you for all the many ways in which we get to help take care of others as well, too, including our pets. Watch over these boys and girls, O God, and all of us as people of the sheep of your pasture. In the name of Jesus, our shepherd, we gather and pray. Amen. Amen. You guys can go in peace. And goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of your life. Need a hand? Hey, Charlie. Good morning. Peace. Good morning. Reading from 1 Peter. Near the back of your Bibles, 1 Peter, who talks earlier in the letter about being sheep and about taking care of the church and of life and of people and taking care of God. And chapter 4, somebody holler out the verses to me. Beginning of verse 11? Oh, 8 through 11. Thank you. 1 Peter, chapter 4, beginning at verse 8, the second reading. Peter writes, "Above all, maintain constant love for one another, for love covers a multitude of sins. Be hospitable to one another without complaining. Like good stewards of the manifold grace of God, serve one another with whatever gift each of you has received. And whoever speaks must do so as one speaking the very words of God. Whoever serves must do so with the strength that God supplies, so that God may be glorified in all things through Jesus Christ. To him belong the glory and the power forever and ever. Amen." Here ends the second reading. The Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew, the 22nd chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. When the Pharisees heard that Jesus had silenced the Sadducees, they wanted to scream and shout, "Yay, Jesus!" No, that's not in the Bible. But when they heard that he had silenced the Sadducees, the Pharisees gathered together. And one of them, a lawyer, asked Jesus a question to test Jesus. "Teacher, which commandment in the law is the greatest?" He said to him, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind. This is the greatest and the first commandment. And the second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets." The gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. So I have a nephew. I have three nephews, but I have a nephew getting married this coming Saturday. Hunter and his bride, Holden, if you guys are watching, good morning. God bless you here this this wedding week, the last week of their engagement. So several months ago, I and plenty of other family members and friends received the invitation in the mail with the big green cursive print, RSVP. Which I quickly glanced over to figure out what I needed to do. But it says, "Please RSVP online at da 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 da." RSVP. RSVP. I'm not going to try to do the French pronunciation of that. We can just stay at RSVP for a moment and think about, if you will, stewardship a bit more today. Stewardship month, stewardship season. Oh, gosh, talking about stewardship. But how God takes care of us, how the Lord is our shepherd, or the Isaiah text about how God wipes every tear from our eye and provides a whole lot more than that. About being stewards of the manifold grace of God from 1 Peter chapter 4, or about how to love God and love neighbor as Jesus proclaims in today's gospel text. So the RSVP part, apart from Hunter and Holden, might stand for four other words. One is we are journeying towards Reformation Sunday, Most of us just consider trunk or treat or Halloween coming up, or Reformation Sunday coming up. The R might stand for Reformation, or that we are in the Reformed tradition. And part of that, 1517, was a breakout for Martin Luther, not because of all of a sudden, wow, look at what the Bible says, but in part because, gosh, wow, look at what the people around me are saying. We can't handle being oppressed by the Roman Empire and the Pope and the Roman Catholic Church of the 1500s. We are having to pay extra money just to have our sins forgiven. At least that's what it feels like, Martin Luther. And so he wrote against having to pay money to have your sins forgiven. But yet he also talked about giving money freely because of God's grace and love and mercy to extended to all of us. Part of that Reformed tradition reminded us and Martin Luther not just about the money aspect, but he focused on God's Word, that God's Word is our great heritage, this hymn we just sang a moment ago, or a mighty fortress is our God, and one little word, Jesus Christ, that little word subdues and takes care of the devil. We also were reminded in the Reformation that we're all not a divided church, but we're all one holy Catholic and apostolic church across the world, Catholic with a little c, meaning universal or worldwide, that we are all part of one church to glorify God in the name and through Jesus Christ as we are led by the Holy Spirit. Yes, we have different settings and situations, and some of us are Orthodox, and some of us are Roman Catholic, and some of us are Lutheran, and some of us are other Reformed traditions like Presbyterians and Methodists and Wesleyans, and some of us are Anabaptists and Baptists, and the list goes on, and some of us are Evangelicals and non-denominational. But we're part of this one big, holy, Catholic, or Christian and Apostolic Church. And that's why on Reformation Sunday we'll be singing, "The church's one foundation is Jesus Christ, her Lord." Martin Luther reminded others of this old statement that including in 1 Peter, that talks about that we are the bride of Christ, that we as the church are the bride of Christ, that Christ is the groom, and the bride is not necessarily Holden, Gasquay, marrying Hunter Patterson, but the bride is the church. Everywhere. And the bride gives gifts, and the bride's family gives gifts to the groom, and the groom gives gifts to the bride, and gifts are always shared. And as you've come together and form a marriage, you become a household, and you have to take care of that household. And that's stewardship, taking care of one another and everything that God has blessed us with. So the R just might remind, and RSVP just might remind us we're part of that Reformed or Reformation tradition. RSVP, the S might remind us that in that Reformation time, there were different soles or onlys. We stand by grace alone, or we stand on Scripture alone, or we stand on faith alone. Sole, faith, sole Scriptura, sole grace. And Martin Luther said it's ultimately because of what Jesus Christ did for us, how Jesus Christ paid our debts, forgave us of our sins. Around 1523, maybe you do the math and take away 1523 from 2023 and you figure out how long ago that was. 6 or 7 years after the Reformation started, Martin Luther writes a pamphlet, a treaty, that reminds us of not only the soles, sole scriptura and grace and faith and Jesus Christ alone, but that we are considered part of the priesthood of all believers, he says in this 1523 pamphlet. He talks about none of us are priests necessarily because of being ordained, but we're all the priesthood of all believers, that we are all, as Christians, are invited to live out God's word, God's grace, through faith alone. And that as priests and as Christians, we're invited to always return to God and give to God our best selves. And that includes our money and our time and our possessions and signs of God's gracious love, including our talents. This instrumental ensemble that helped play for our opening hymn a moment ago, 5 or 6 individuals, all with different vocations, which will be the V in the RSVP, by the way, vocations. comes from the word vocare in Latin, to be called. And Martin Luther says, you are called, we're all called to be part of the priesthood, but we all are called to be Christian and if you've been baptized, and therefore to live out your baptismal faith with your vocation. And it's not about your occupation. All of those 5-6 individuals up there have different occupations, or even retired occupations these days, with other interests and loves. But they all have different occupations, but they all have the same vocation here today, praising God with their instruments and with their directing and through their music, just like you. This is their stewardship, but this is also our vocation and our stewardship today as you gathered, as you heard the word from Isaiah that said to praise God. As you might have lifted up prayers this week for places like Israel and Hamas with all the bloodshed and terror and the awfulness there, kind of like Isaiah 25 did, you lifted up prayers because you were stewards of the manifold grace of God, and this is part of your vacation to pray to God. You lifted up prayers for other loved ones. You took care of this week, I'm sure, of someone else, even today, to get to St. Mark's. Maybe not each one of you drove. Maybe someone else drove and someone else rode in the passenger seat or in the back seat. And you took care to get to church, get to worship, get to St. Mark's safely as you were led by the Holy Spirit. You took care of one another. You maybe even fixed coffee for someone else this morning. You maybe fixed food, or you'll go out later today and pay for someone else's food. It's all about being stewards of the manifold grace of God, but also it's our vocation to live as Christians each and every day, regardless of your occupation or your retirement status, even of your childhood status. You can still help take care of others, because that's still your vocation in the name of Jesus Christ, to be a Christian. Vocation. RSV, and then the last is P. To continue to proclaim God in Christ Jesus, RSVP, to proclaim God in Christ Jesus and to praise God through Christ Jesus because of all the gifts God has given us and all the ways in which God takes care of us, as Psalm 23 proclaimed. There were multiple ways, 5, 6, 7 ways of how God takes care of us. The same thing was revealed in Isaiah 25, not just about wiping tears away, but how God will provide refuge for so many. And this is what the church does. We provide refuge and sanctuary, and we help when people are in trouble or in need. Refuge and sanctuary, wiping away tears, food, sustenance, faith. God continues over and abundantly to continue to bless us and strengthen us. And we are invited then to return our thanks, to return grace, to give of ourselves back to God. Maybe this day you already dropped an offering in the offering plate that was already taken up and taken back to where the offering is kept before it is counted and celebrated, but we give thanks for the offerings. I was standing in the back when Jean walked in and placed an offering envelope in the plate. Maybe many of you did. We've had 264 different giving units. A household is a giving unit. 264 this year, and through the end of September, those 264 had contributed over $467,000 to this ministry of St. Mark's. That's another way of looking at stewardship, by what you have given and shared, and thanks be to God for those financial gifts. Psalm 23 says, I shall not want, and yet at the same time, we do ask and request your time and your talents and your money to help take care of St. Mark's and to help take care of the world in which God has placed us, so that we can be good vocational ministers, each one of us, in this place and for our community. RSVP. God bless Hunter and Holden in their upcoming marriage. God bless St. Mark's as you are the bride of Christ. God bless us all as Christians in our vocational calling to be Christians and to serve God with all our heart, soul, mind, and strength, as Jesus proclaimed, to love God and to love neighbor as self. Thanks be to God. Amen. Let us pray for the church, the world, and all in need. And the prayers are printed today in your bulletin. Merciful Father, we offer with joy and thanksgiving what you have first given us, ourselves, our time, and our possessions, signs of your gracious love. Receive them for the sake of him who offered himself for us, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Shepherding God for green pastures and still waters and all the beauty of the natural world, including places near us, the Appalachian Mountains and the Atlantic Coast, our neighborhoods and our favorite places. Thank you for the beauty of the earth. Help us to be good stewards of your creation so that water, air, earth, animals, plants, stars, and humanity can all continue to be called good. Today, we also pray for the nations of the world and for all who hold positions of authority, that they govern in accordance with your holy vision of justice, Lord God, and strive toward the goal of peace and prosperity for all. Amid wars, poverty, and inequality today, we include the nations and peoples of Israel, Gaza, Ukraine, Russia, Cameroon, Venezuela, and these United States of America. And we pray for all experiencing valleys of illness and grief that they may be healed and comforted and find rest in the presence of the Good Shepherd who walks beside them. We especially pray and lift up today your servants Barbara, Drew, Martha, Judd, Pat, Ruth Ann, Betsy, Ron, Carol, Andrew, Liz, Wendy, Nancy, and all that we now name aloud from our lips or silently in our hearts. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Gracious God, into your hands we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your unending love and amazing grace through Jesus Christ, our Shepherd and Savior. Amen. The Isaiah text included the promise of a feast of well-aged wines, of marrow. And so, mindful of that text associated with Jesus Christ, who lived for us, died for us, gave his own well-aged wine and bone marrow for us. We remember how in the night in which he was betrayed, how he took bread and gave thanks and broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And then after supper, he took the cup and gave thanks and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant of my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. The gifts of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. You may be seated. Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. Let us pray. We give you thanks, O Lord our God, for this feast of well-aged wine from the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Send us forth in his name that we may be good stewards to love you and to love neighbor as ourselves, as Jesus did. In his holy name we pray. Amen. I'll say stewardship, one more note. I appreciate Brian and Margaret. Margaret and Brian for preparing being here early this morning to help prepare communion for families and children and musicians for help being here early this morning to practice and prepare to help lead worship today. That RSVP wedding invitation type of thing. I'll also mention that in another 10 days or so, the congregation, you will get an invitation by mail and maybe a reminder online or two as well, but an invitation in the mail, including a pledge card or something like that, of which you're going to be invited to RSVP, to return that card, if you please, RSVP. And we do hope you please to return the card with a way that you will help support the ministry of St. Mark's during this fall stewardship campaign. And now, Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless us now and forever. Amen. Amen.